sponsored by Sprite. It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. I'm Ernie Johnson. I've got the legendary Shaquille O'Neal by my side. And tonight, it'll be the Memphis Grizzlies going up against the Chicago Bulls. For Chicago, they managed to take Game 1 of the season series against this team, looking to seal their series advantage with a win tonight. Hey, Dr. O'Neal, what do you make of the job that Dave Yeager has done with the Memphis Grizzlies?
He steady keeps his cool throughout any situation, Ernie. He always keeps things in perspective for his team. He keeps it light, never gets too intense on the sideline, and he always puts his players' health first.
That sounds a lot like you.
Yes, why they call me the doctor.
Because you keep it light. You're steady. You always keep things in perspective.
Yes.
All of these things sound like you, Dr. O'Neal.
I'm changing my name to the Big Dave Yeager.
I think that's a winner. Let's go to Kevin Harlan.
Two teams, two conferences. It's a road game for the Bulls in this one. 2K Sports is proud to present NBA basketball. Alongside Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. And the Grizzlies on friendly ground as they continue this homestand. They've really been on a roll. They've gone 5-1 in their last six games.
Looking at Memphis, of all the surprises the NBA has provided us with this season, they may be the biggest of them all.
I agree, Clark. I mean, coming out of the preseason, it would have been very difficult to make a case for them being one of the NBA's top teams, and yet here we are, and here they are.
And in Chicago to start out, let's check out Chicago's starting lineup. D. Rose and Jimmy Butler, the backcourt. Gibson is the four with Gasol in the middle. And it's Snell in at the three. Rose, good!
And the layup just gift-wrapped right there. I mean, he had a clear path to the basket.
Bulls on D. Their last game, a win against San Antonio, looking to carry that into this one.
And what they did well in that game, Kevin, was attack the rim. They got to the free throw line, and they converted once they got there.
Yeah, it was hard-nosed basketball and fundamental basketball at the same time. Physical and aggressive, that's a recipe for success.
You know, the Grizzlies are the kind of team that perhaps fans around the league can overlook or undervalue or even forget about at times, but they're always going to be there because they're tough, they're physical, and they're talented.
Oh, no, he may have gotten injured right there. He's in a lot of pain.
Yeah, Clark, that did not look good. Let's keep our fingers crossed that it's nothing too serious.
Boy, you can't help but feel for him. I mean, one moment you're doing what you do best, and the next, the situation's really out of your hands. I really hope he's okay.
And Memphis making a change here. Goofus is checked in. The shot is off. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. Well, guys, as you were talking about, Memphis not a big budget franchise or one with a history that runs so deep that often fans overlook them.
That may be true, but it's given the Grizzlies a very underdog attitude that I think the franchise and the team and the fans have embraced.
Just five to shoot. Rose attacking. Takes a shot at the elbow, and it's in after a nice bounce off the right side. Rose has got his second bucket of the night.
Well, he's off to a good start, and he's a guy who we know. I mean, if he gets going early, he can give you problems all day.
Outside, Green. Kufis rejected by Gasol. The Bulls have gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. Conley against Rose. Kufis grabs the miss. For Memphis, they've gone 0 of 3 from the field to start the game. A chance here to get a quick injury report. And now we'll send it over to Doris Burke for an update on Marc Gasol.
Kevin, I got some news from the Grizzlies head athletic trainer. Not what we wanted to hear, guys. It sounds like it's a very serious injury. This injury could be a huge blow to a team with title hopes this season if he were to miss significant time. Kev, hoping for the best on the sideline here.
Thanks, Doris. Guys, the only thing you can wish for is that the prognosis isn't quite as bad as they're making it out to be.
Yeah, exactly, Kevin. I don't know, though. I mean, one way or another, it seems to me as though it's going to be a long time before we see him back in uniform.
Yeah, such a shame, guys. You always hate to hear of any player getting injured, and this one, this does not sound good.
Here's Kufis, right now averaging 5 points a game. And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two.
Well, you know, for teams in the NBA nowadays, it's all about getting bang for your buck. Mike Conley out of Ohio State, one of the great value contracts in the league, and with all the analytics and general managers looking for value, Memphis happy to have an all-star caliber still player like him still locked up through 2016.
Now here's Rose. He had 22 points in the win against San Antonio. Passes it to Butler. Back to Rose. Beyond the arc. Count that one. Rose has got 7.
How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
Conley kicks to Allen. Randolph in the post. Working on Gibson. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
And now a look at Pau Gasol here. Some tremendous numbers for him over the last 10 games. 5th in rebounding. And he's been quite an offensive threat, averaging enough points to put him in the top 20 in scoring.
And Steve, how about his rank in the rebounding department? I mean, the guy is physical, he's strong, and he relishes contact and banging around in there.
Courtney Lee, he's checked in for Tony Allen. Rose, good.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Conley kicks to Green. 1:29 left in the first quarter. Lee outside. Moves back up. And he gets it to go as they call the foul. He's on his way to the line for one more.
He has such a knack for scooping up the rebound and then making a defense pay.
Some changes for Memphis. Vince Carter, he's checked in for Kupas. And it's Udrich in for Mike Conley. And it's Rose penetrating. Green with the block. Here's Udrich, defended by Butler. And Green gets it to go.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
And that's going to open things up for them on the perimeter going forward, Clark.
Snell kicks to Rose. Unloads. Cannot hit. And Memphis the other way now. This game coming on the heels of their win against Toronto.
And I think everybody who was at that game would agree it was their defense that really won it for them.
Yeah, they were all over the place, flying all over the court on deep. The kind of hustle that pays off big time for you.
Butler kicks to Gasol. On its way from Rose for 2. Here's Gibson, and he makes good on the layup. Gibson's got 5.
They have got to put a body on him, because otherwise, with his agility and athleticism, they're not going to be able to contain him on the offensive glass.
Green, the pass to Lee. Looks for Randolph, gets it to him. Poked loose, and that's out of bounds. Memphis will retain possession. Shot clock at 6. Shot from the wing, and the Grizzlies check on 2 more. Here's Rose. No good. And off we go. A close game now starting the second quarter. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Bulls?
They've done a nice job on the offensive boards here, guys, and I think that was the difference in that first quarter, really pounding the offensive glass.
Well, they set the tone early with their mindset, their tenacity, and their hustle. I mean, that's the way they've come out, and it's served them well.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, as the second quarter gets going. Taking a look at the Grizzlies. They've got Carter. Allen is out there with Udrich. Then there's Kupas, and it's Green in at the 4 slot. Shot clock at 5. Kolathis dishes to Green. Chance there to take the lead. Missing. Chicago leading.
Pau Gasol over the last few seasons dealing with a number of lower body injuries. Knee tendonitis, plantar fasciitis, groin, toe. Say, Kobe had suggested to him to try to really slim down to lessen the pressure on his joints.
Here's Calathes. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up. And Powell never really the brutal type, but for 7-footers, getting as wide as possible can really reduce the pounding on those joints.
Yeah, it does. They say every 5 pounds takes some significant wear and tear off your joints. And we've certainly seen that be effective for Tim Duncan. He's leaned up considerably, and Powell able to play both power forward and center. I think the lighter weight will serve him well.
And we're starting the second quarter, about a minute gone. Conley kicks to Allen. Outside Conley. To the wing on the left. Shot clock at 6. Heinrich with the steal. Feeds to Miritich. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot. And we can talk all we want about their passing, but from 3-point range, these point guards have been filling it up for the past month. Michael Conley is 2nd. The 4th spot held by Aaron Brooks.
Well, a lot of the point guards in the NBA don't get enough credit for how well they shoot the ball. So give this group their due. Some outstanding long-range shooters right there.
No question about it, Steve. And being able to knock down the 3-ball as well as this group can makes them so much more effective at the point guard spot. It really causes problems for the defense.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to Doris Burke for an update. Hi, Doris.
Yes, Kevin, Memphis coach Dave Yeager paid dues for years coaching in the minor leagues. But he did more than coach. He was the GM, ticket vendor, business manager, and a halftime act. He said he loved the passion and spirit of that work, but there were also tough times. Guys, those struggles helped prepare him for where he is today.
A long road, but he's here now. Thanks, Doris. That is good. Allen's got his first bucket in this one.
You know, the height difference there is huge, but he canceled it out with great body control in the air.
Exactly, Steve. He got to the hoop and wouldn't allow himself to be manhandled by the big boy.
Nice shot by Brooks.
I don't know who was supposed to be on him there, but clearly a mistake by the defense.
And there's the foul. It'll go on Aaron Brooks. That's his first foul.
Personal foul. Second team foul.
Green kicks to Conley. And it's Chicago with the rebound.
The defense was ready for him that time, and they had to be. He is so powerful in the lane.
Brooks outside. Fires from deep. That's good. And now an 8-point Bulls lead.
It was a slow start for him, but he started to take off since we hit the second quarter, guys.
Conley, the pass to Kufis. 3 minutes of action so far in the second quarter. Count the bucket. And that's now 6 points for Conley.
Boy, nice work inside. Tough to get that shot over a big defender like that.
Oh, that takes skill and creativity, Steve, particularly on the release to make sure he doesn't get a hand on it.
You know, size-wise, this is not a great one-on-one matchup for him, but he got that shot to go.
But you wouldn't know it by how he finished. That's a nice hoop there.
Here's Kufis. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game.
That's something they need to do more of. Get after it on the glass. Go get those boards.
Any extra possessions that you can get, either through steals or rebounds, are so critical in this game.
And so it's Memphis with it. Aaron Brooks missing his last shot. Green breaking loose. Conley gets the bucket.
That's pretty much been the norm for them, getting their points off assists and great ball movement.
Nice rhythm and flow for this team. Tremendous communication and alertness.
Now here's Brooks. Heinrich from outside. The Grizzlies pull it in. Conley's got 4 rebounds now tonight. 52 seconds left in the first half of the game. And there's the foul. It'll go on Aaron Brooks. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game. So Memphis going with almost an entire new group here. Zach Randolph's checked in for Kufis. Carter comes in for Allen. Courtney Lee, he's checked in for Nick Calathes. And it's Udrich in for Mike Conley. And Green gets it to go.
Now they're not showing too much respect for him defensively, are they?
35 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. And Brooks, here we go. It's rebounded by Randolph. Randolph's got three rebounds so far in the game. And Udrich gets the lead. And it's out of bounds. The Grizzlies able to retain possession here. Green dishes to Lee. Back to Green. Carter outside. Some nice passing there by Memphis. No good from Lee. Gasol with it. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against San Antonio. Nice shot by Brooks. With one on the clock. Second quarter ends. And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters.
Aaron Brooks had a terrific quarter. He has 11 points, and from long range, he's hit 1 3-pointer.
Yeah, and you'd expect by the end of this game, I'm sure the numbers are going to look even better.
And it's been a back-and-forth game so far with no ground given through the first. Third quarter starting here now. Aaron Brooks with a strong contribution so far in this one.
You know, he spoils us with his performances game in and game out. And so far, just another big scoring night for him.
Typically, when he puts up that many points in the first half, he's going to follow it up with a better second half. We'll see if that happens here.
Here's who Tom Thibodeau is starting the second half with. Gibson is the four with Gasol in the middle. Brooks out there with Heinrich. And it's Mirotić in at the three spots.
You got to love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of grinded out physical game.
Yeah, that was your game, Clark. Pound it inside and take the ball right to the defense.
That's what I tried to do, man. I knew my limitations.
So they take the lead. That's now 8 points for Jeff Green.
They're relying on their three-point shooting and getting pretty good results right now.
Yeah, in fact, three of the last five makes are from beyond the arc.
Heinrich from outside. Stokes with the rebound.
Tough to hit that shot when you got the defense right in your shirt.
Kirk Heinrich in his 12th season out of Kansas. Remember covering this guy in college. Still a quality defensive combo guard. A 6'4", tremendous IQ and anticipation. Really helps him at the defensive end. And he's, I think, a little underrated offensively, too.
And he gets it to go. And now a 3-point Grizzly lead. Chicago's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. The drive by Brooks. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. Michael Conley picks one up.
A chance to check out some of the stats for Zach Randolph. This past month or so, he's really given the fans a lot to watch. Averaging about 19 points, 14 rebounds, and 2 assists. And the work that impresses me the most is how he's attacked the glass and provided so much help on securing rebounds for his team.
Yeah, it's huge, Steve. I mean, when you add up the offensive glass work that turns into second chance points, I mean, the rebounding that he brings to the table has been huge.
John Lure, he's checked in for Memphis. From 11 feet away, knocks it loose.
Well, they need a shot or two to fall here soon. They're only 1 of 4 since the break.
The drive by Allen. Conley with it, guarded now by Aaron Brooks. Conley, the pass to Allen. Looks for Randolph, gets it to him. Shot clock at 6, can't get it to go. And in Chicago the other way. They traveled to Memphis last time they faced the Grizzlies and came away with a win.
And the physical nature of their last meeting was just as they had hoped for. I mean, they drew a ton of fouls in that game and went on to win it.
And there's the foul. It'll go on Aaron Brooks. That's his third foul of the game. Nick Galathis, he's checked in for Lure.
Nick Galathis.
Conley against Brooks. Conley into the lane. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. Brooks kicks to Heinrich. It's Brooks on the wing. Covered by Conley. Nice shot by Brooks. And I want to hear your take on what Steve was just talking about, Clark. How big a role do you think foul trouble played in that win?
Yeah, it was large. Humongous, I think, because of the foul trouble. That forced them to use lineup down the stretch that they weren't really comfortable with. So it was a big, big factor.
Here's Calathes. Aaron Brooks picking up that last basket.
Randolph.
So it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Zach Randolph is a terrific rebounder and scorer. In his prime, he just mark up 20 points and 12 rebounds a night, every night. He's a little bit on the downside now, but still a player you've got a game plan for.
Vince Carter, who's checked in for the Grizzlies. Lee comes in for Michael Conley. Now let's send it to Doris on the sideline.
Well, gentlemen, Courtney Lee acquired by the Grizzlies last season in a trade with the Celtics. And as teammate Mike Conley has put it, Courtney was a huge, huge piece. People overlook him, but it's key that he's able to stretch the court for us. It gives Zach and Mark more space, and he can definitely lock up defensively. Kevin?
He's been a great fit as a two-way player on the perimeter, too, Doris. Thanks. Bulls trail by three. And Randolph, now 33 years old, had that knee injury a couple seasons back.
Yeah, his rebounding remains excellent, but you know, we've seen his scoring wane just a bit, both in volume and the percentages. Not quite the go-to scorer he was a few years back, but still very effective player.
Now here's Lee. Aaron Brooks missing his last shot. Green dishes to Carter. The feed to Lee. Six on the shot clock. Pass to Green. From about 16, misses off the right iron.
Rebounds are split just about down the middle in this game, Clark.
I'd venture to guess whichever team is able to maintain that energy level on the glass will have the upper hand the rest of the way.
Oh boy, he is just cold as ice. I don't think he's going to be the one to help them cut into the lead.
For Memphis, they've gone an even 50% from the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. Here's Calathes. Brooks covering. Carter on the wing. Fires it up. Good. Great play by Calathes to set it up. Carter's got the lead up to three now for the Grizzlies.
And assists like that have typified their effort today. Great ball movement.
Really an example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Brooks with the bucket. 12 seconds left to play in the third. It's stolen by Heinrich. And Heinrich riding the magic carpet all the way to the other end.
And once he took off, it looked like the defense just had no interest in getting in his way.
That's one where you just give up the 2 points and move on.
That concludes the third quarter. It continues to be an exciting neck-and-neck game. It's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
Well, it had to be this play, don't you think, Kevin?
Sure.
This is just a phenomenal pass. Made the defense look like they had no idea what was going on.
What precision with that pass.
Beautiful.
Tony Allen is out there with Green. Then it's Udrich. Then it's Lee. And it's Randolph in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the lineup in the game for Memphis.
The defender there in the neighborhood, but not quite close enough. Good shot.
And so it's Memphis with it. Following the three-pointer by Doug McDermott. Green, the pass to Randolph. And that one goes long. The Bulls leading by four. Outside Rose. Got a piece of it. The three. Grizzlies with the rebound.
And he's having all sorts of problems with his shot.
I'm not sure he even has a shot right now, Steve, to be quite honest. Not a reliable one anyway.
Nice shot by Randolph. We're just over a minute into this final quarter of play. Rose attacking, and it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Now, this is why the breakaway rim was invented, for plays just like that.
Well, he almost brought the whole thing down, Clark, by hanging on that long.
Yeah, he did.
It was a great dunk and also a great game we've got here.
Here's Randolph. No good. And in Chicago the other way.
Major defensive lapse right there. I mean, he's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. You've got to stay attached to him. They're lucky he couldn't punish them for it.
Now here's Rose. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Derrick Rose has always had an effective floater. It's a must-have shot for any point guard. He said he developed it on the playgrounds of Southside Chicago. He didn't call fouls, so you just had to find a way to get your shot off before the contact.
And the Grizzlies making a change here. Conley's checked in, and that one's good.
And now both of these clubs really in a groove here.
Already a high-scoring game, but it has become an offensive showcase down the stretch.
And it's Rose penetrating. And there's the rejection. The Grizzlies trail by three. And Rose working to develop his floater with, Steve, his left hand as well.
Well, you don't see many players who can make a floater with either hand. I mean, something like that with his quickness, that would be impossible to defend.
Now here's Rose, following the miss by Michael Conley. Outside Rose. And again, no good by Chicago. Memphis has gone 3 or 4 from long range in the game. Here's Conley. That is good. Conley's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Unbelievable basket. What a huge height disadvantage. I thought for sure it would be blocked.
Not this fella, Steve. Not at this stage of the game. He was going to get to the rim no matter who was standing in the way.
Boy, he has been struggling mightily in this quarter, guys.
True. He really seems to have tightened up a bit for whatever reason. He looks tight.
Now here's Lee. Conley kicks to Allen. Green left side. A fadeaway. No good off the front iron.
Tell you what, he can be really frustrating as a shooter. All you can do is grimace because he just can't find the range.
Rose attacking, and that one's good. And the Bulls lead by three.
You know, his ability is matched only by his energy, guys, to me. He's usually in the middle of everything for his team.
Now a timeout called by Memphis. They're trailing by three. 1:36 left in the fourth quarter. Tyus Thomas has checked in for Memphis. Taj Gibson's checked in for Chicago. Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Thanks, guys. I was able to hear Dave Yeager coaching his team during that break. Despite the deficit, he told his guys, "I've got confidence in you. We've had our backs against the wall before. You know what we need to do. Kevin, can they retake the lead?"
It has not been an easy quarter for them, at least offensively speaking.
Outside Butler fires the three. It's good. This time the assist from Rose. And it's a 6-point Bulls lead.
Tell you what, they haven't exactly been shy about letting it fly from deep here in the second half.
You know, Steve, if you have the lead, you can afford to be a little comfortable with the 3-point shots. You just don't want to fall too much in love with them.
Now here's Green. The rebound by Gibson.
All the defender had to do there was just stay close to him, and he did.
Rose against Conley. It's stolen by Green.
It's going to take something special, maybe a miracle, for them to come back right now.
How about a little luck?
So deflating for a team, coughing up the ball at one end, and then it turns into immediate points at the other end.
And it's just as much of a boost for the team getting those easy points off the steal.
And so they foul intentionally. The Grizzlies making a switch here. Lee's checked in. Gasol kicks to Rose. And the shot no good, a bit short. Memphis has gone 3 or 4 from long range in the game. Lee dishes to Randolph. Yes! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
Time after time, Zach Randolph getting it done.
Now Rose, and now we've got the intentional foul.
Yeah, no question, the right call at this point. You can't let them just dribble it out.
That's right. I mean, you got to send them to the line and hope for a few misses.
And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a 4-point ball game.
And that ought to do it. I think any chance for a miracle comeback just went out the window with those free throws.
Now a timeout called by Memphis. They're behind by 4. We've got 13 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And here's Conley outside. Money! And what a sensational bucket to bring down within one.
You know, on defense, even on an inbounds play, you can't leave three-point shooters alone on the perimeter. They pay for it there.
And he cannot get the first one to drop. Tough one to miss. And the Grizzlies making a change here. He's able to hit the second one, and that will put them up by two. Ooh, offline. No good there. And so the big win by Chicago in a tight game. Clark, it was anybody's game right to the very end.
Yeah, it was. The coach is happy with the outcome. This team kept their emotions in check and got it done.
Thank you for joining us for this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. For Clark, Stephen Doris, and the rest of the crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time. Last but not least, here is your Jordan Player of the Game, Derrick Rose.